congratulations. You banished the demons with Colby Covington. But what a fight, man. Tell me a bit about a couple of weeks removed now. How you feeling?
Feeling good. You know, it's kind of one of those fights you let your nuts hang, you go in there and get it done, and then, you know, you can't wait to do it again.
Jorge Masvidal seems to be flip-flopping on this. He goes, you guys aren't violent enough. You guys have a fucking violent war. And then he goes, they didn't even try their wrestling.
Yeah, so that's the name of the game. You know, he has become everything that he said that he didn't want to be, which is, you know, someone who's all trying to get fame, trying to get attention. It is what it is. You know, he's getting this nice little 10, 15 seconds of fame. You know, after I go ahead and smash him, it's going to be all over.
How's the hand doing?
Hand's doing good. You know, a couple more weeks in this, I'll be out, ready to punch, and I'll be back.
Who'd you rather fight next, Connor or Jorge?
Definitely Connor. You know, at least I'll get paid for whooping somebody's ass, so definitely Connor.
How do you think the fight with Connor would go?
Like all my fights, you know, I was just kind of like a Mack truck. I'd run over him, you know, probably in 3 rounds, get him out of there.
Small for you?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's not even a question.
Do you think you'll ever meet Colby again in the Octagon?
You know, I don't know. You know, I don't know how much that fight took out of him. You know, when he's done and we actually see that, you know, he's recovered, we got to let him get back in there, get one under his belt, then we can see if he has what it takes to come back and make it back to the top.
Obviously, you won, so I'm asking you, like, hypothetically, but why didn't you shoot for a takedown at one point during that fight?
No, it was one of those. Like I said, you got to let your nuts hang, mano a mano, go out there and, you know, see who's the best man. And, you know, I got the job done.
Could you fight like that against Jorge Masvidal?
I could fight like that against anybody that I want. It's a matter of me being smart and thinking about longevity in my career. You know, I could, Masvidal, I can go in there and dominate him if I want, easily.
What happened there the other day? It was a bit of a fracas between you?
He wanted 10 seconds of fame. He came to my media day just to make a little bit of noise, but he didn't do nothing. That's it. I stood there and I asked him to do something. He did nothing.
You beat Tyron earlier in the year, and you beat Colby. That might have put you in contention for Fighter of the Year. With all due respect to Jorge, he beat, you know, Darren Till, he got knocked down. He beat a guy who went 0-3 in the UFC. I count the Lawler fight as a loss.
Absolutely.
And then he goes and beats a guy who's 1-1 in the last 3 years. That's hardly Fighter of the Year material.
No, it's not. But what he did is what I call the hype hat. You know, they put the hype hat on him. So he has the hype now. So everyone thinks that he's this killer, but he's the same exact guy that's winning and losing, a run-of-the-mill fighter. So it is what it is. Until I expose him, you know, everybody's going to keep putting this hype on him.
How would that fight go?
You and I both know how that's going to go. You know?
Tell me, being honest, man to man, you know, I'm being honest with you. I'm a big Colby fan. I was back when going into that fight. Did he earn your respect over those 5 rounds?
Yeah, he did. I mean, he stood in there. You know, any man that's willing to step in there with me, that, you know, they earn a little bit of my respect, you know. But, you know, he went in there and fought great. You know, he showed that he was tougher than I thought he was. I thought he would break a lot sooner, but, you know, he didn't. He stayed in there and he fought good. But at the end of the day, the better man won.
Conor McGregor.